So now I bring you this point. Live what Marcus said. If you knew that Marcus Garvey said, a race without knowledge of its history and culture and origin is like a tree without roots, would you continue to run from your past and walk around the place like an ignorant jackass? Would you hear the word history? You think it is the world's biggest mystery, not realizing that your past determines your present, and your present determines your future life events. Would you ignore the fact that Africans built civilization on the Nile, while the Caucasian neighbors were living caveman style? Would you dismiss the fact that the black woman gave birth to all races, and the black man brought enlightenment to far and distant places? If you knew that Marcus Garvey said, if you have no confidence in self, you are twice defeated in the race of life. With confidence you have won, even before you have started. Then, would you continue to bleach the black out of your skin, disrespecting the Creator by committing such an egregious sin, using your hands to perpetuate self-hate, while allowing your mind to create another lost degenerate? It is lack of confidence why some men dress to advertise their rear end, or wear their pants so tight they cannot even bend. Does this madness negatively impact the minds of our youth, producing social misfits often so savage and uncouth? Should we ignore these ills and hope that they go away, or confidently eradicate them from our mind every night and every day? If you knew that Marcus Garvey said, fear is a state of nervousness fit for children and not men. When a man fears a creature like himself, he offends God in whose image and likeness he's created. Would you then, black man, still demonstrate the fear of being a man? Would you continue to be a liar, a murderer, a robber, and a con man? Would you continue to lower your dignity, degrade your life, creating sorrow, havoc, mayhem, and grief with your gun and knife? It is the fear of trying that promotes beggars, idlers, and thieves. It is the lack of fear that promotes all the progress we can conceive. So rise up, black people, and purge your heart and soul of fear. Help comes to those who help themselves. I hope I made it clear. Let righteousness and truth be your daily quest. Fear will only cripple you, and that surely ain't no jest. If you knew that Marcus Garvey said, the greatest weapon used against the Negro is disorganization, would you still persist in your efforts of self-destruction, constantly spreading disunity, disloyalty, and self-hate and aggression, given our recent past of slavery, oppression, savagery, and barbarism, compounded with the impact of miseducation inflicted by colonialism? Shouldn't we, the victims, be solidly united to prevent another Holocaust? Or is it a fact that we have not yet learned the lessons from our past? Did Marcus, Malcolm, Martin, Marley, and Mandela come to us in vain? Or is it just we love suffering and self-inflicted pain? So rise up, black people. Get organized to slay your mental enemy. Let the power of the one God guide our aim to our united